This is part two of rational exponents. In part one, we use this definition. B to the 1 over n equals the nth root of b. So for instance, if I wanted to do 8 to the 1/3, this simply means the cube root of 8, which is 2. So I could write anything with the rational exponent where there's a 1 in the numerator as the something root, in this case, whatever the denominator is, the cube root of 8. So I could write it using a radical. Now what we're going to do is find out what this means, b to the m over m, where there might not be just a 1 in the numerator. So in red here, I have one of the laws of exponents, b to the m raised to the nth power is simply b to the mn. So let's say I was going to do 8 to the 2/3. Notice that 2/3 could be written as 1/3 times 2. Okay? So really there's two ways I could think of 8 to the 2/3 if I want to kind of go backwards and write it as something raised to some power. I could either put the 2 outside the x outside of the parentheses or the 1/3 outside of the parentheses. So this leads me to two different ways of writing this. I can write 8 to the 1/3 squared, or I could write this as 8 squared to 1/3. So I'm really just using my laws of exponents and the fact that 2/3 is 1/3 times 2. Alright, so, but what does 8 to the 1/3 mean? It means the cube root of 8 squared. And again, over here, raising something to the 1/3 means the cube root of 8 squared. And in fact, this is two ways of thinking about what 8 to the 2/3 means. So notice the base here, 8, it's in the radical both times, right? But I either write it as a root, and the root comes from the denominator, right? The root's 3, so I've got the cube root, and then what's in the numerator, I get to square it. Or what's in the numerator, I can square it first and write as 8 squared and take the cube root. So let's finish simplifying this. On the left side, if I do what's inside parentheses first, I have the cube root of 8. That just means 2. And then I have 2 squared, and that's 4. On the right-hand side, I would have to square 8 first. And that would be 64. And then I have to think of what the cube root of 64 is, and that's 4. Now, personally, I think it was easier the way I did it on the left because I worked with smaller numbers. So if I take the cube root first, I get a small number 2, and I only have to square it. And that's the way I'm going to suggest it. But basically, here's the idea. If you have a base raised to some fraction, you take the denominator, and it's going to be that root. So you're going to write it with a radical using the denominator as the index. So we've got the cube root of 8, and then the numerator, the whole thing's going to get raised to that power. So let's go back and write that out. B to the m over n simply means the nth root of b to the nth, or the nth root of b to the m. Okay, now here's a way to remember this. Think of flower power. So what you're going to think of is you've got this fraction. That's going to be the power, right? Like I raise it to the nth power in both of these. And this is going to be the root, or the index, right? Index. Think of a flower. Okay, so you have a nice pretty flower. Okay, obviously, I was not meant to be an artist. Okay, and all the roots are down here. Okay, here's the idea. It's sort of like a fraction. See, you could think of the land right here, the earth, as the fraction bar, and above it's the flower, and below it's the root. Remember, the flower has the power. Flower has the power. And the roots are underground. Okay, so that helps, hopefully. The roots are in the denominator and the power is in the numerator. Okay, so think flower power. Flower power. Okay, so let's go back. All right, so here we are, flower power. 8 to the 2/3. So the root is in the denominator, so that's why I have the cube root of 8, and then the power is in the numerator, the flower. Think of the flower, power. Flower in the numerator, because that's above the ground. Okay, let's go on to another problem. So let's say you have 9 to the 3/halves. Okay, let's do the same thing. So I always work with the denominator first, because that's the root. So I want to write the root part first. So in this case, it's going to be the square root. I don't have to write the 2, but you can. So it's the square root of 9 cubed. Now, what's the square root of 9? 3. And then I'm going to cube it. Now, I said you could write it the other way, right? You could do 9 cubed and then do the square root of all that. But how many of you know 9 cubed? Do you know it? Well, if you do, no problem. If you do 9 times 9 is 81, then you have to multiply that by 9, so you get 729. And then you'd have to figure out the square root of 729. Well, how many of you know that the square root of 729 is 27? Well, it is, but you might need a calculator for that. So you will get the same answer, but the arithmetic is not as simple. Okay, before going on, I just want to go over this definition one more time with a little details. We're only working with real numbers still, so the full definition here is that if m and m are positive integers greater than 1, with m over n reduced, so we're going to take a reduced fraction here, then it's true that b to the 1 over n equals the nth root of b, and b to the m over n equals the nth root of b to the mth, or the nth root of b to the mth, as long as the nth root of b is a real number. Okay. Now, the next part of this is, what if you had a negative exponent? So, what if we had b to the negative m over n? We're just going to use the same rule that we used with negative exponents before. It's going to be equal to 1 over b to the m over n, and the little caveat here is as long as b to the m over n is not 0, because you can't have a 0 in the denominator. So this is just the formal way of writing these three definitions. So let's just try a few problems. You might want to put this on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, the first one. We've got negative 16 to the 3/4. Now, remember, the base is 16. This minus sign is not part of the base. So we just write the minus sign again. And now, 16 to the 3/4, I always do the root first. So the denominator is the root, so we want the fourth root of 16. And then we want to cube it. So we write the minus sign again. Fourth root of 16 is 2. Again, the minus sign just is hanging out in front. 2 cubed is 8, so this is negative 8. Next one. What do you do when you have a negative exponent? You first need to rewrite that as 1 over 8 to the positive 2/3. Now, the root is 3 this time, so I'm going to write the cube root of 8 and then square it. So I still have that 1 in the numerator. Cube root of 8 is 2. So I have 1 over 2 squared, which is 1/4. Next one. The minus sign's inside the parentheses, so this time the base is negative 27. So I'm going to take the cube root of negative 27, and then the power is 4, flower power. Cube root of negative 27 is negative 3, and you have to take that whole thing to the fourth power. So remember, that means negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. It's going to be positive 81. And the last one, we have 4 ninths to the 3/halves. So we take the numerator to the 3/halves, over the denominator to the 3 halves. So in the numerator we have square root of 4 cubed, and in the denominator we have square root of 9 cubed. Alright, so the numerator we have square root of 4 is 2, so we have 2 cubed. And in the denominator, square root of 9 is 3, so we have 3 cubed. So 2 cubed is 8, and 3 cubed is 27, so our answer is 8/27.